tonight on Parker and Parker. 34 hours and counting until the first shots are hit at Congressional. We'll talk U.S. Open live with Christine Brennan. Mark Cuban paid how much for this bottle of champagne and tipped what? Plus, it's the end of an era, our era. And guys, listen up. A very special guest stops by to help say goodbye.
Having come close and having finished second here, being in contention so many times through the years, I really believe that I can win this tournament. But just as when I was trying to win my first major championship, if you focus so much on the result, if you focus so much on winning, sometimes you can get in your own way.
Julie Parker, that was Phil Mickelson just a few hours ago out at Congressional Country Club. Phil turns 41 on Thursday. He is 0-20 in the U.S. Open.
Obviously
nice pants. You like the orange pants?
Nice pants.
They might be burnt sienna if we can go back a few years to the Crayola box of 64 with the sharpener in the back. Anyway, U.S. Open starts in 2 days. Phil Mickelson, certainly a fan favorite. Maybe this will be his time to break through. Hey, everybody, we are Parker and Parker, and that's going to be the last time I ever say that. Julie Parker, what's up, girl?
We'll say it Sunday on the radio.
Oh, that's right. We're on the radio Sunday, 9 to 1.
Why are you trying to push me out the door?
Welcome to the Alex Parker Show. 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. on 106.7 The Fan. We will be on the radio Sunday. So we do have one more Parker and Parker. This is the last television version. How are you?
I'm good. You know, when we looked at the Open in the beginning and saw all of the antics over the years, it's kind of surprising that I ever actually managed to get a job after.
Did these people at Prince George's County not see what you've been up to? I love
now
the
they
sequence,
have.
Girl.
Thank you. I teased the fact that you were going to wear the Clinton Portis shorts, and
I
you
had
bailed.
Them on and I had them onto the golf course today, and they were a big hit.
You're trying
not.
To live up to the sequence.
I didn't want this. This is a big tape for us. I didn't want this to live forever like the museum, and I'm in these shorts from Target.
Right.
Julie Parker is leaving ABC 7 and News Channel 8 to go to
the Prince George's County Police Department. I will serve as the head of their communications department until they see that.
Until they see the tape.
Montage.
We have a ridiculous guest planned right now. If I had to name a guest to have on our show, on the last show in the A block, it would be Christine Brennan, Hall of Fame sports writer, USA Today. You name an organization and she writes for that organization. Christine, I got to see you out of the club today at Congressional. Pretty sweet place. How are you doing? And thanks for joining us.
Oh, my gosh, Alex, Julie, great to be on with you. And I'm sorry, I didn't realize this was a watershed moment. My goodness, but congratulations to both of you.
Thank you, Christine. So, first of all, why did you air quotes when you said congressional? Like it's a
pretend. I don't know, because it's fancy. It's very fancy. It's very fancy.
Oh, that's your fancy. Yeah.
Christine can attest. We were there today in the very spacious media center. This thing, Christine, is the size of the Mormon temple at this point.
Well, and it's smaller, though, than previous ones I've been to. I've been lucky enough to cover a fair amount of U.S. Opens over the years around the country. And unfortunately, because of what's going on in the media, there are fewer journalists covering golf, fewer journalists working for newspapers, fewer journalists anywhere. And so the press room keeps shrinking. It's like, honey, I shrunk the press room, you know. But it's still, you're right, it's very spacious. And it goes on and on, doesn't it, Alex? I mean, there's the food area, and there's the press, the interview area. And then there's the big sitting area around the interview area. So, yes, there's a lot of room, probably enough to have at least a putt-putt, you know, 18-hole miniature golf course in there.
What would you say is the storyline of this U.S. Open, other than Tiger's not in it?
Yeah, and that's it, number one, of course. I mean, isn't that ironic? You know, we're talking about a golf tournament, the national championship of men's golf, and the first story is who's not in it. But, of course, that's huge because it's Tiger Woods, and he's injured, and he's out. But otherwise, I think it's Phil Mickelson. I wrote about him today. I was just on the phone with my editors finishing up and for tomorrow's USA Today, guys. And, you know, I think Phil, you know, he's had five second-place finishes, five runner-up finishes, and this is his. I mean, he's the rock star, the last remaining rock star in golf, don't you think? And this is his for the taking if he can do it. I'm not going to say he's going to do it, but he turns 41, as you mentioned, in a couple of days, and the reality is he's got there will be a shrinking window here for him. Without Tiger, I think there's a good shot that he could make a run for it this week.
You and I were there today when he spoke, and he sort of downplayed it, and he said, you know what, I'm going to enjoy this week, and I'm not going to worry about the outcome. we don't really believe this, do we? This man is very worried about the outcome.
Well, we were both in there. You're right. And, I guess I can kind of believe him and also not believe him. And, Alex, I would say that you understand why he just wants to play the game, of course. Anyone who's ever played golf at any level, bad or good, knows that you just go out and try to hit shots. I mean, you're not thinking, okay, that's going to be a 6 or a 9 or a 100 or whatever, the way some of us play. But I think that, so I do believe that, but no. And he even said deep down at one point in his press conference, he said, deep down, yes, I want this. And so I do think, he's a smart guy. He knows. He's had 20, this is his 21st Open. He's won 4 majors, never won an Open, and I think it would just make his career if he were to do it this week.
Christine, I talked with some folks at Main Street Tickets in Gaithersburg today about all of those reports that since Tiger was out of it, ticket sales were down 20%. He said they're not seeing that at all and that tickets are going for above face value. There's not a large supply of tickets out there right now. What do you make of that with Tiger being out?
I read those same reports, Julian, that the fact that maybe prices were dropping 20, 30%. On StubHub and whatever. I don't know. I will say that I didn't see just massive crowds out there today. I only spent a little time outside, but it wasn't teeming with fans. Now, again, it's Tuesday. The tournament starts Thursday. But my sense is they probably had some tickets. I think I saw a press release, I don't know if you guys did, where there were tickets available for the practice rounds. I think the tournament itself is sold out. But there's no doubt. It has to be, not having Tiger, just like there's been a Tiger effect, I think there also has to be a Tiger non-effect. I think that just common sense would tell you that that would be the case.
This will be your last prediction, Christine Brennan, on Parker & Parker, the TV show. Who is going to win the U.S. Open?
Great question. I think just pure emotional heart says Phil. Maybe he really does pull it off. He says he's playing well. I think it's going to be one of the new Europeans, the young guns, Luke Donald from my alma mater, Northwestern, or Lee Westwood finally winning a major. So if you make me pick one of those two, I'll say that the Northwestern guy wins. And we don't win a lot in Northwestern, so I'd be happy to see that happen, Luke Donald.
Christine Brennan, thanks so much for joining us. What are you doing every Tuesday at 9 o'clock for, I don't know, the rest of your life?
I don't know, but I'll
you can come
miss you
sit
guys.
Right here.
Listen, I wish you the best. Julie, you take care, and we'll talk soon, I hope.
Thanks, Christine.
See you, Christine.
Thank you.
She didn't really say, I'll be right over.
Coming up.
She's awesome.
What's Christine the most Brennan. You've ever spent on champagne?
$6.
Tops.
Tops.
If you're NBA billionaire, cost is no object. He's a pretty good tipper, too. All the juicy details next.
Congrats on your new endeavors. Good luck with the Prince George's County Police. Prince George's? I thought she hated Prince George's County. Anyway, good luck in Prince George's County. And please, God help us all if they ever give you a gun. We love you.
That really was the beginning of the end. That was the beginning of the end of us.
If Hall & Oates had any idea that this is what we're doing with their classic ballad, they would not be happy. Daryl and John, we're sorry. They're not breaking up, are they?
No, they're not.
Because one of them didn't get a job with the Prince George's County Police Department. I'm sick. Maybe the Kleenex.
Take
for
off.
God's sake.
Let's,
okay, what are we doing in this block?
Let's stick to the script, shall we? We're talking Mavs.
We've waited until the last show. We're going to do
take
a
your
script
Kleenex.
Now.
Take your Kleenex.
Okay, what are we doing, Joe?
Let's go to the videotape, shall we? Someone else said that.
Okay, this is the Mavericks celebrating. I've been in U.S. Open, I haven't made
look
it out
it.
Of congressional country.
Cuban's got a Cuban.
Who won the NBA Finals? Oh, Dallas. Okay,
how
thank you.
How much does that thing weigh?
The cigar or the trophy?
The trophy.
I don't know, but I believe where this is going is they had some sort of ridiculous celebratory party in Miami, correct? After the final game?
Was it Miami?
I think it was Miami.
You were assuming that I prepared for this grand finale show. They go to a bar, and they walk into the bar. People start tweeting, Dirk and Mark Cuban just walked in.
Yeah.
And then Mark takes out the old black Amex and makes a purchase.
Oh, it's a black Amex.
I'm guessing. I don't know what color his credit card is. Do we have the video of what he buys? There's Dirk.
Okay, how much was this bottle of champagne, Julie, reportedly?
He looks like Eric Clapton from the side, doesn't he?
Looks like Hall & Oates from the side. How much was this bottle of champagne?
This is a $90,000 bottle of champagne. Now, in theory, it's called Ace of Spades. It's supposed to cost $23,000, but you know how there's that markup at the restaurants?
You got a heck of a discount. I'll give you $9,000. I'll take it. $9,000 for this thing?
It's something.
It is big. I'll give him that. It's a big bottle.
It's like half the size of Dirk. It's about 3.5 feet tall.
Yeah.
Then Cuban tips. You got a tip.
How much do you tip on a 90 grand thing?
What do you think?
10%? You leave 15% would be 9, would be 13.5.
20 grand.
He's a good tipper, this man.
Is the tip.
That's impressive.
Mark Cuban leaves. Can you imagine?
Maybe Dan Snyder, when the Redskins win the Super Bowl, will do something of the ilk. With the stuff.
Do we have the urinal shot?
Now there's a tease on television. Okay, this is a bit much. I don't even know if this is appropriate for television. It's only 9:13. My kids aren't even asleep yet. What is this?
So he's in the restroom and he's talking to someone.
Well, I will say you're not going to just leave that with somebody. Hey, could you hold this? I really got to go. And you're not going to leave it on the sink so that when somebody washes their hands and you're focused on. In this case,
the task at hand,
it's gone. So what else do? You hold the darn thing. And then the trophy, too. Bada bing. Are we done with this segment? Can we just go back
please.
To saying goodbye to each other?
Yes, please.
Okay, Julie, you read the tease.
Oh, he's 23 years old and has already had a statue built in his honor. And his biography is a runaway bestseller. How do you explain the mania around Tim Tebow?
Why are we teasing Tim Tebow?
Because we've got a famous Gator alum to help explain it all.
Guys,
she's hot.
If I'd written the tease, it would be, guys, don't turn away. In our next segment, you know her, you love her, everybody wants to go out with her, she's next. That's what the tease should have said. We'll be back.
Meet Julie and Allison that one night. Meet Julie and Leslie. Oh, Julie, there you are, the night you gave me the black eye. Remember that night with Allison? Another good night.
Frankly, I'm kind of excited about this. If you'll notice, I've been eyeing this piece of property next door for a good chunk of time.
That one.
Oh, you like that? I like that one. Okay, unlike the girl next to me, these people appear to stay together at some point in their lives.
Brad and Angelina?
Peaches and Herb. Okay, there we are. By the way, Julie Parker, before we introduce somebody that I know every guy out there wants to see.
You crushed me.
I'm driving in the car, you know, like for the last week, and every song, it's So Lonely by the Police. It's Taylor Swift, You Belong With Me. Oh. It's like, are you controlling the soundtrack of my life?
It's like when you break up. Every song is about.
Please.
Breaking up.
Okay, we are now joined by Alison Starling, rock star anchor. Only on our last show did we get these wonderful guests. Where have you been for the last year?
No. Sleeping.
Yeah.
Yes, this is actually not only the first time I've been on your show, but the first time I've ever seen it.
Oh, wait.
Because, not because I don't want to see it, but I'm always asleep at this time. But now I've moved to evening, so this is fun.
She's our 5 and 11 o'clock anchor now.
And I wanted to be able to say goodbye to Julie, personally.
Thank you, friend.
Such a great friend. And we don't know what to do without her here.
I know.
You can sit here.
Didn't you freak when you heard it that she was leaving TV?
You know, it's funny. I remember the day we met. I don't know if you remember this, but I just remember seeing this gorgeous woman in the newsroom and thinking, she's so great. Who is that? It was like my first day. And she had just gotten back from maternity leave and looked like $1 million. And I remember we struck up a conversation and have been friends ever since.
So that's almost 9 years.
Yeah, 8 or 9 years ago, and we've had some fun times. And everybody's just so proud of you and excited. It's going to be a fun new adventure.
Thank you very much. I wish everyone was so supportive.
What? Here's what I think we do. Her first day on the job in a couple weeks, at about 3 in the morning, because she's going to be in charge of all these things that happen, when the press needs to know, let's all start calling her house with questions about something that happened in Largo.
Are you going to disguise your voice?
No.
No?
Me disguise my voice. We're psyched for you, girl.
Thank you.
How are you feeling? Are you excited?
I'm very
nostalgic?
Excited. I mean, it's been 14 years in local news, 13 at All Britain, at News Channel 8 or Channel 7. Mm-hmm. So it's just, you know, everything will be brand new.
Yes.
And leaving all the people who I've come to know and love.
How are you going to continue your sports addiction? Is there going to be some outlet for you to continue?
Well, Palmer Park is here.
Uh-huh.
And FedEx Field is here.
There you go.
So I'm not mentioning this necessarily to Brad Parker, who is a Cowboys fan, but there could be a few more games in my future.
Since she used to do this, she could cover the couch burning in College Park when they beat Duke. You can go out there and get angry at the kids.
I might be en route one.
A lot of folks don't know that you have a serious connection to sports.
Your dad
played football at University of Florida.
He did in the 60s. They call it the Silver 60s, all those guys. And they still get together. He played right around the time with Steve Spurrier. And you would think he still played at Florida when football season comes around.
And the Denver Broncos.
And the Denver Broncos briefly before he was injured. But
it's okay.
Yeah, but, you know, SEC football is like a lifestyle, just like Redskins football, anything else. So I grew up around huge Florida Gator fans, and still it's like, you know, going to church when it comes to be football season.
Do you love Tim Tebow?
Yeah,
like, are you nuts for this guy?
You know, I think we all have enough bad guys in sports, right? I mean, I think that's part of the allure of Tim Tebow, is he's unique. We see all the guys who get in trouble and who, you know, are disrespectful one way or the other of women, whether it's actually criminally or not. It happens, but not with Tim Tebow. So it was funny, he was on Jon Stewart on The Daily Show about his book, and, you know, he's 23 years old, and Jon Stewart says, well, don't people usually wait till they're 24 to write an autobiography? I mean, I think it's, you know, it's a lot for someone so young, but he's certainly done a lot too. So we're proud as Gators of what he's done. I don't know him, but I guess having gone there makes me somewhat of an expert, right?
You like the Dew?
Oh, no, not so
that
much.
That was like a long time,
yeah,
like
not
a year
so
ago.
Much.
You did the morning show for a long time here at ABC 7, and now you're in the evenings. How are you adjusting to this?
You know, it was almost 8 years getting up at 2:30 in the morning, and last week was my first week anchoring at 5 and 11, and I thought I would just sail right into it physically. You know,
you
I thought,
did?
Oh, this will be, I did not. It was hard. It was real. I was waking up a ton in the night. It's a huge adjustment, but so great. And this week I'm feeling like myself.
Normal.
So,
so much better for your body.
It's exciting.
A lot more people will see you now.
Yeah.
The 5 and the 11.
I know. And I don't have to go to bed at 7 o'clock in the morning, 7 o'clock at night. It's so exciting. So,
thank you for coming on.
Thank you for having me, Julie. We're really going to miss you.
Thank you.
But
very
I know
much.
We'll see each other.
We will.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Well, we are coming back to put the wraps on this final edition of Parker and Parker with some highlights and lowlights of my time on this very serious sports show. And I'm told we'll have a few surprises mixed in.
I can't believe this is happening. I'm going to miss your smile, your sense of humor. I'm going to miss your warmth, but most of all, I'm going to miss your 73-inch TV set and watching the Caps together. All the best to you. I know you're going to do great. We'll miss you a lot. Hey,
Julie, look what they're doing to me, trying to trip me up. Don't miss our radio show finale this Sunday on 106.7 The Fan. Alex and I will be broadcasting live from Nationals Park, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. We'd love to meet you in person. We hope you come on by if you're coming to the game. We'll take your calls and your texts as always, and Alex will solicit for
exactly.
my replacement.
Come on out and see us. I need the flowers for Joel. Come on in, interns. Jimmy's coming
Aww.
In. We started with flowers for you.
Thank you, Jim.
From the Safeway.
Thank you.
And we're ending with flowers from the Safeway.
Thank you,
Jimmy,
very
thank
much.
You. We have more guests. I have no idea
thank
who these
you,
people
Kyle.
Are.
Thank
I'm
you.
Just told in my ear we have more surprises. Who's coming out? Jewel?
I don't
we
know.
We have people. I don't know.
Thank you, our friends at Founding Farmers. Oh, look at this cake.
Jen, thank you very much. From now they bring the food.
May your
well, look at this.
Be, what's happening?
Look at this. That's sweet.
Hi. Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks. Thank you. Slap shot,
thank you,
right?
Slap shot. I got to read goodbye. That's it for this final edition of Parker and Parker. Thank you, Terry Cornwell, for creating Parker and Parker. Thank you, my friend, Ron Parker. Thank you, all of you. Appreciate it. Thanks. Thank you, honey. That's so sweet.
Hey, Julie, it's been great working with you all these years here at ABC 7. You truly are a class act, even if you must say so yourself.
Julie, I wish I could be there in person to tell you all of this, but I'm in Berlin.
We certainly will miss you. You're a good friend, a great journalist, and clearly a leader in this newsroom.
We're going to Chipotle!
Probably see more of you working there than we do here on Channel 7.
We wish you the best.
Congratulations.
We will follow you anywhere. I can't help
remembering how you. Like I said, we're sad to see you go, but don't worry, we'll still be picking up that phone to give you a call in your new job.
Julie, everybody around here is crying in their milk, blah, blah, blah. What a shame Julie's leaving. This is so sad, end of an era.
I wish you all the best in your new endeavor.
It just won't be the same without you. But at least, Julie, we'll always have Twitter.